We're here with Ahana from Slovenia, but not actually from Slovenia. You're actually from the United States. So why Slovenia and why Eurovision?
Yes, I'm American. I moved to Slovenia some years ago. I have a Slovenian husband. And because I'm a singer and a songwriter, I kind of made my career in Slovenia. They really accepted me. I performed in national song contests there, have songs on the radio in Slovenia that I also sing in Slovenian. And it's just been very accepting experience kind of in the Slovenian music community.
So there's no negative criticism on the fact that you're singing in English in Malmö?
I think that, of course, this happens sometimes when a country doesn't sing in their own language. I think it happens in every country. Someone or some people will think, why aren't she singing in, you know, our language? But I think that Slovenia does this some years and other years not, just like many other countries. Sometimes we sing in Slovenian, sometimes we sing in English.
Do you see Eurovision as the start of a pan-European career, because it's been great for some international stars? Do you see yourself following in their footsteps?
Of course, I think it's a wonderful opportunity for any artist to have the kind of exposure that Eurovision brings you. Even if you don't win, I think that people can see you and connect with you, and I think there's a chance of doing well with your music beyond that.
But don't you think that's got kind of a stigma to it, that it's too typical Eurovision?
I hope not. I mean, I think that people try to be as modern as they can from certain countries, like we did this year. And I think that our song eventually, the kind of music that I work on, I also already have international releases with different collaborations of electronic music producers. So I will just continue in that route.
Speaking of modern, your song is one of the most modern songs in this year's Eurovision. Do you think that's an advantage? Because there are a lot of ballads in this competition. Do you think yours will stand out because of it?
I definitely think that naturally it will stand out because it's an up-tempo modern song amongst many ballads, as you said. But I still think that the song needs to also be good and strong and well-performed. If it's not, even if it's up-tempo, it still won't be accepted.
It's a dance song. You co-wrote it. There's a bit of dubstep in it. Was that done deliberately? Because that's not really typical Eurovision sounds. Aren't you afraid that people will not accept it?
Well, I think, as any artist would probably tell you, you have to do what you feel as an artist and not just please what you think will work for Eurovision. And I think people know that. They see the originality of people who do something a little different, even if it's not traditionally Eurovision song. So I still think that it's still got enough really cool elements of pop in it that can connect with all kinds of viewers, even if they don't like dubstep.
We only saw a rather static performance with you alone on stage, but we saw a rather modern video to the song. Can we expect something like that on stage in Malmö?
Absolutely. Basically, what happened with that performance video, the static one, we had just finished the song, so we had no time to prepare anything. The performance for Malmö will be a lot more energetic with dancers, great choreography, and I expect it will have much more of an impact. And the video is also more me. It's what I envisioned, people and the team that I selected, and definitely that's what I would prefer to have as our visual for the song.
Last question, did you check out the competition and do you have any favorites?
Yes, of course. I haven't seen every single song, but I really like Norway. I like Ireland. I like Sweden. I like Russia and Malta.
Thank you and best of luck.